What if you could build an aquarium that takes care of itself? But regular fish tanks are messy and a lot of work. So I created a self-cleaning, modular aquarium with a unique filtration system that eliminates constant maintenance. I'll show you how I built this amazing 5-gallon aquarium for a second grade classroom, a new way to enjoy fish without all the hard work. It could transform fish keeping forever. To begin, I wanted to make the tank special, so I added a colorful background that looks like ice cream with rainbow sprinkles. I attached and trimmed it to fit the back of the tank. In addition, I decided to brighten up the black edges of the tank using multicolored adhesive tapes I got from Amazon. By applying a different color to each side, we give the tank a rainbow effect that's sure to capture the kids' attention. It's a lively tank that they'll absolutely love. Now let's move on to the filtration system. For our filter box, I'm using this clear container, the same as the ones pet stores use when you buy a fish. We'll turn it into our filter box. For this filter box, I designed and 3D printed a special lid with holes to connect our filtration system. Furthermore, I included little caps and extra holes to improve the filtration by adding some houseplants that help clean the water by removing nitrates. To connect the filter box to the tank, I made a U-shaped bridge that attaches the filter box to the bottom right of the tank. This helps water flow between the tank and the filter box, keeping the water clean. Next, I designed and 3D printed this water flow platform that sits at the bottom of the tank. It has grooves that guide water towards the back corner where our connector is located. The goal is to keep the bottom of the tank clean by preventing waste from settling. Now comes the exciting part. I want to share with you my own invention, a modular aquatic planting system. It's a special container I designed and 3D printed that fits perfectly in the tank and works seamlessly with the water flow platform tubing. For the water flow platform, I also made an L-shaped tube with holes. It sits under the platform and is a key part of our filtration system. To assemble the modular aquatic planting system, first, I cut aquarium-safe sponge to fit as a lid for the 3D printed container. What's great about this system is that it doesn't have to be a single container. It can be made up of several planting modules. This means you can arrange the pieces any way you like, making it easy to set up and take care of your tank. As you can see in my provisional patent, each planting module has a sponge layer on top with slits about 1/2 inch apart. These slits hold the plant stems securely while allowing roots to grow down into the nutrient-rich substrate. Next, I filled the container halfway with substrate, which is necessary for plant growth. The cool thing is, you can have different sections of the planting module with different types of substrate, depending on what each plant likes best. For example, some plants prefer sandy soil, while others thrive in richer substrates. This customization helps the plants grow better and makes your aquarium look amazing. Then, I applied aquarium-safe glue around the edges of the container and attached the sponge lid, sealing the substrate inside. This design prevents the substrate from escaping and keeps the plants firmly in place. Even if you turn the planting module upside down, nothing falls out. It's perfect for maintaining a clean tank and ensures that the plants stay in place. For the plants, I chose Monte Carlo because they create a beautiful carpet effect and will help reduce maintenance. Using tweezers, I carefully inserted the stems into the slits in the sponge layer, making sure the roots would reach into the substrate. While planting, I sprayed the plants with water to keep them moist. For the filtration system, I added aquarium-safe sponges to serve as filtration media, which will trap debris and support beneficial bacteria essential for the nitrogen cycle. I also included a small heater to keep the water at the right temperature for the fish and plants. The water pump is installed on the right side of the filter box and connected to the tubing that leads to our water flow platform at the bottom of the tank. Now that our filtration system is ready, we can put our planting module inside. Carefully, we place it, and now we can fill the tank up with water. Also, we need to put some water in our filter box. Because the water circulation doesn't move the surface of the tank too much, for now, I am adding an air pump with an air stone to help improve water movement. Then I created the siphon effect with the U-shaped bridge by inserting an airline tubing inside it. The tubing goes all the way to the top. Then, carefully placing our U-shaped bridge in place, I pull the air out of it, and that connects the water of our filter box and our tank. Then I connected our water pump and turned it on. For the finishing touches, we used a small aquarium light from Amazon and customized it by wrapping it with the same colorful paper as the tank's background. So now it was time to let our tank cycle and our plants adapt. 2 weeks later, just before delivering the tank, we added the final touches. The Monte Carlo plants had some melting, but recovered nicely after I trimmed them to encourage fuller growth. We also placed houseplants on top of our filter box to add life and help absorb nitrates. Using the same sponge system from our planting modules, we kept their roots moist and in contact with the water. Hopefully, this will work well. To add a bit of fun to our tank for the kids, we bought this interlocking building block set from Amazon. My wife helped me put it together, and this is what we made. It's like a castle and a playground at the same time to give joy to our tank. As you can see, it has openings that are perfect for our betta fish to swim through. We also glued the pieces together to keep everything secure. To anchor it and make sure it stays at the bottom, we placed some rocks inside the castle playground. We also built a container for the air stone using the same building blocks. Since there were extra pieces, we made an additional castle for the kids to play with the tiles. The next morning, we took the tank and went to Petco to buy a betta fish. We wanted a colorful one, and we found a beautiful koi betta with bright colors. It was perfect for our tank theme. With our new betta, we headed to the school. We planned to set up the tank while the kids were on their break to surprise them. But we arrived 5 minutes early. As soon as we walked in, the kids got super excited. They were so happy and full of questions. We started filling up the tank, surrounded by the kids. Thankfully, it was time for their break, so the teacher took them outside, giving us a chance to set everything up. We placed the tank on a desk at the front of the classroom. We filled it up, set up the filtration system, and then added our fun castle playground decoration. We gently put our colorful betta into the tank to acclimate, along with some red shrimps. We also added water conditioner to make the water safe. I also got some school and fish stickers, so the students could paste them on the bottom part of the glass where the planting module is. Then we turned off the lights to help them settle in. After about 25 minutes, we released the betta into the tank. He started exploring right away. Then we released the shrimps, and our betta began chasing them a bit. Maybe he was curious or a little hungry. Soon the kids returned from their break. Their faces lit up when they saw the tank.
Oh my god! This is so cool! Is there fish in there?
Then, the teacher suggested they name the betta. Each group of students picked a name, and the suggestions were written on the board. After voting, the name Messi won. But they also voted on a last name, and McFlurry was chosen. So our betta was officially named Messi McFlurry. The kids were thrilled, and so were we. Seeing their happiness made all the effort worthwhile. Messi McFlurry seemed to enjoy the attention, swimming proudly around his castle playground. This experience was heartwarming. We not only created a beautiful aquarium, but also brought joy to a classroom full of excited kids. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to One Fish Tank for more aquarium projects. Feel free to leave any questions or comments below. I'd love to hear your thoughts. Until next time, happy fishkeeping.